In this video, I want to show you how to calculate water quality index using Microsoft Excel. In the previous video, I've shown you and discussed with you the concept of water quality index. I've shown you the different method of water quality index, the standard to be used, and I will also discuss about how water quality index came about. And also, we talk about the classification or categorization of water quality index value. So in this tutorial, we want to use one of the methods we have discussed to calculate water quality index in Microsoft Excel. And important things that we need to note is that when calculating water quality index, we consider water quality parameters. You must have the result of your water quality parameters. And also, selected parameters must have standard limits prescribed by either WHO, Bureau of Index Standard, or Nigeria Standard for Drinking Water Quality. So you must have a standard. And number three is selection of water quality index method. And among that, we have the weighted arithmetic index method. We also have the Canadian Council of Ministers of the Environment Water Quality Index. We have the National Sanitation Foundation Water Quality Index. And we have the Oregon Water Quality Index, and so on. Then, for this very exercise, we are using weighted arithmetic index method inside Microsoft Excel. So, and for this very method, water quality index formula using Brown et al, we have three steps that we need to follow. And step one is to calculate the unit weight factor for each parameter by using this formula, where the unit weight factor is equal to K over Sn, where K is equal to 1 all over 1 over S1 plus 1 over S2 plus 1 over S3 up to plus 1 over Sn. This S1, S2 is talking about the standard you have adopted. Now, the Sn is equal to standard desirable value of the nth parameter. On summation of all selected parameters, unit weight factor must equal to 1. Then step 2 is to calculate subindex value using this formula, where your subindex value is equal to Vn minus Vo all over Sn minus Vo all multiplied by 100, where your Vn mean concentration of the nth parameters, and Sn, which is the standard desirable value of the nth parameters. Then your Vo is the ideal value of the parameters in pure water. And generally, the ideal value for most parameters is equal to 0, except for pH. And because for pH is not equal to 0, then to calculate the subindex of pH, we have to use this very formula here. So we are going to be seeing all this in our calculation. Then the step 3 is to combine step 1 and 2 to get your water quality index. In this case, your water quality index will be equal to summation of your unit weight factor multiplied by the subindex value. So this is the formula we are going to use in calculating water quality index using the formula designed by Brown et al. Let's go to Excel for the calculation. So in Excel, I've shown you that we are going to use the water quality index developed by Brown et al. And I've shown you the formula to use for the calculations. So, and this is just the summary of what the result should be. So once we are done with the calculation, our results should fall within these water quality index categories. So now, for us to do that, for the practical purpose, 7 parameters were analyzed for this study, and the following is the lab result for the parameters. So where we have our 7 parameters here, and in this exercise, we are adopting a standard for our calculation, and the standard is the BIS. So this is the standard. And the result for these parameters analyzed for site 1, site 2, site 3 is also tabulated accordingly. This is it. And worthy of note is that the choice of parameters depend on the researcher and also the objective of the study. Likewise, parameter can be physical, chemical, or biological in nature. However, the selected parameters must have standard limits prescribed by WHO, BIS, or Nigeria Standard for Drinking Water Quality. So you must have a standard. So now, this is our lab result, and this is the standard we are adopting. So let's calculate the water quality index for site 1. Let's go to this sheet for our calculation. And also, this is the formula so that we will not forget. So the first thing is to have your parameters in one column like this. I've arranged this column to make it easier for us. So this for site 1, we have our parameters. Then you have to copy the standard. So let's go back to this sheet. Let's copy the standard. I've arranged it accordingly, so I just need to copy. Then let's go back and paste the standard here. So I have my standard. So the first thing to calculate is 1 over Sn, which is 1 over this very standard column. So to do that, come here and enter equal to 1 divided by this and press enter. So to calculate for the rest, just drag and to the end, click and drag. So we have calculated 1 over Sn. Now here, this column is saying that summation of this very 1 over Sn. So to do that, just highlight and find the auto sum. So this is the sum, auto sum of this 1 over S. So you can just copy this, copy and paste here. So right click and paste value. So, or you can just paste and drag it to calculate for the rest. Now, having calculated for the rest, we want to calculate our K. So to calculate for K, this is the formula. K is equal to 1 all over summation of 1 over Sn. So which means it will be 1 divided by this column. So to do that, come here and enter equal to 1 divided by this. Click enter. Then here, just click and drag. So we have calculated for this as well. Then we have to calculate for this column. So this WN is our unit weight factor for each of the parameter. And if you remember our formula, this formula, this one, WN, which is our unit weight factor, is equal to K all over Sn. You can see it here. WN is equal to K over Sn. So that means this column is equal to K, that is this column, all over Sn, this standard. So just enter equal to K divided by Sn. Press enter. Then you can click and drag to calculate for the rest. Then there was a statement that on summation of all selected parameters unit weight factor, it must be equal to 1. So if I click on auto sum, you can see it's equal to 1. So summation of all this must be equal to 1. Now, the ideal value. The ideal value for all these parameters is equal to 0, except for pH. So which means for this pH, pH is not equal to 0, but for the rest is equal to 0. So you can drag to input 0 for the rest. However, for ideal value of pH is 7. So enter 7. This is it. So for this column, mean concentration, the mean concentration of the points in question, that is the result you got after your lab analysis for each of these parameters, that is the mean concentration, VL, here. So let's go back to our lab results. For site 1, this is the result. So which means you just copy it, right click and copy. Then let's come back to our calculation sheet. So here, paste your result here as value. So this is the value we got for site 1. Now, we need to calculate now for sub-index. For calculating for sub-index, let's go back here to look at the formula. Now, for sub-index, because pH is ideal value is equal to 7. So, as a result of that, this is the formula we are going to use to calculate for the sub-index value of pH. Whereas for the rest, this will be the formula. So let's go back to our working sheet, calculation sheet rather. So for this one, remember the formula here. If I bring this one here, you can see here. Let me expand this a bit so that you can see. So for this sub-index value for pH, this is the formula, which means the value you got for pH minus 7 all over 8.5 minus 7. Now, here for site 1, the pH value is 7.4. This is 7.4 minus 7. That gives me 0.4. Then 8.5 minus 7 minus this 7, that gives me 1.5. then 0.4 divided by 1.5, that gives me 0.267. so I'll copy this value, copy, then come back here, so paste it here. Now for the rest, because the ideal value for the rest parameters is equal to 0, in that case, what you will do here is that for the remaining parameters, it will be Vn divided by Sn. That is Vn divided by Sn, the standard. So here, you input the formula is equal to Vn. This is it, the concentration you got from your lab results, divided by the standard, that is the Sn. Then press enter. Then from here, drag it to calculate for the rest. So this is it. So the only difference is the pH. And this is because the ideal value for pH is equal to 7, not 0. So since for these ones, remaining parameters, the ideal value is 0. So that is why we are calculating it differently from pH. So now, after you have calculated for this very sub-index, then we have to calculate for this, which is our Qn. So Qn is equal to this sub-index multiplied by 100. So it means here is equal to this value multiplied by 100. Click on enter. Then you can now click and drag. It will calculate for the rest. Yes, this is it for the rest. Now, we want to calculate for water quality index. If you remember the formula, the water quality index is summation of Wn multiplied by Qn. So let's go to our calculation sheet. So water quality index, since it is summation of this column, then let's calculate for this column. So this column is Wn multiplied by Qn. So it is equal to Wn. This is Wn. Wn multiplied by Qn multiplied by Qn, this column Qn, then press enter. So you can see it has calculated for it. Then just click and drag to calculate for the rest. This is it. Now, water quality index is equal to summation of this column. So let's just auto sum it. Auto sum. So this is our water quality index. So we can now, let's say, fill. Yes. So that we can differentiate it. So we can just say W key I. That is water quality index. Is equal to this. So this is our water quality index for location one. So in the same way, you are going to repeat this step for the remaining sites, as many sample sites as you have. This is the same method you are going to follow to get your water quality index. In my own case, I've calculated for all the three sites in this sheet. So I've calculated for site one, I've calculated for site two and site three. So what to do now is to copy each of these water quality index into a summary sheet. So I have it here. So for site one, this is the water quality index value I got. This is for site two. This is for site three. Now, if you look at here, you can see that the values I got for each of the sample site fall within one of these classes. For site 1, 34.34, it falls within this range, which is good. This is the water quality status, good. And for site 2, this is the value, and it falls in very poor class. Then for site 3, it falls in excellent because it's 2.7. So 2.7 falls within this range, which is excellent water quality status. So this is how to calculate water quality index using the Brown et al. Water quality index formula. So I hope this video is helpful to someone. Please let's see your comments in the description box if you want us to use another method to calculate water quality index, so that you can see the difference, especially in the range and in water quality status classification. So thank you for watching.